Hello, everybody. I just decided to have a virtual launch, seeing as I couldn't have a physical launch due to COVID and everything. So I just decided to come on live here just to mark the occasion, shall we say. So, as you have probably seen from all of my extensive posts on Facebook, that I launched my book today. And so Easons were very kind and Nina to host it. So it's available in Easons and Sheila na Gaeilge in Clochjordan. And my book is available for sale online at childrenoflear.ie. So just to show you, I'm not sure, I think this might be backwards. I'm not sure if you can read that or is it like mirror. But this is my book and it is. I worked with a graphic designer, Deirdre Gleeson, and she. It's all illustrated with my painting. So Deirdre manipulated and layered all of my paintings to create something quite unique that reflected all of my writing. And my writing is all prose poetry. So just to give you a brief viewing of the book, I'll just flick through of all the imagery and everything that's inside of the book. There you go. And if you go to my website on childrenoflear.ie, it explains everything about the book, and I've already put up a number of posts and everything about what the book is all about. So rather than repeating all of that again, so childrenoflear.ie, that's where you can find all the information about the book. So this kind of virtual launch, what we do at an actual physical launch, is just talk a little bit about my journey with the book and my and to thank everybody basically who has helped me along that journey and who has been there for me. So just to give a quick kind of brief overview, history of the journey of the book. So I began, well, firstly, actually, I read the story for the first time since I was a child, in 2015, in the summer of 2015, and I was completely and utterly hooked by the story. And the thing that really grabbed me was Fionnuala's story. So in the myth, hello Andy, thank you so much for and Gaelica, thank you for tuning in. And so in the traditional story there is a storm, so the children are cursed for 900 years, but in the middle of their curse there is a storm and it separates the four children, and Fionnuala is on her own, and this is what's known as Fionnuala's lament. So she it's a big long in the traditional story, it's a big long poem and everything that Fionnuala says about I'm so alone and dark cold sea. So what I connected to that is, like, at the time I was going through quite, not to sound too dramatic or anything about all of this, but I was going through quite intensive depression. And so what I saw in Fionnuala's story, the thing that captivated me, was the water, the ice alone. To me, that symbolized depression, and I just felt I connected with Fionnuala. I felt like I can see my story in her story. I found comfort within her story, and the fact that she breaks free at the end of it, does that mean I can break free too if I follow her story? So, that's where I began. And then in 2016, July 2016, I put pen to paper for the first time. Now, I wrote it originally as a play, which was performed a few times in 2017. And I worked with a wonderful cast, and thank you all so much to the cast, if in case you're tuning in, and two wonderful directors who taught me in college in Bray, and I approached them when I finished my degree, saying, asking, "Will you tutor me? Will you mentor me on the process of putting this play on, between from a directorial point of view, or from a production manager point of view, and you know, the business of theatre, the artistic approach of theatre, and all that kind of stuff." And so the response to the play the audience response inspired me to write the adaptation that is inside of this right now. So the questions that people asked were, what happened to Aoife? So in the traditional story, Aoife curses the children, and as punishment she gets turned into a demon of the sky, is what she's referred to as, and she gets sent into the abyss to roam for the rest of eternity. We don't know what happened to her after that. There's no mention of her in any traditional story I have come across. And so, but people asked me what happened to her and what happened to Lear. When the children leave Lear, the story only follows the children, it doesn't follow Lear, what happens to Lear. So those two questions really got me thinking about this new adaptation. So I started questioning, what does Aoife's story mean? Okay, she's a woman, obviously. I started questioning about Aoife. So Aoife is the mother of the children, and she died giving birth to the two youngest, who are twins. And basically, rather than rambling on about this too much, I mean, a lot of it is already in the book, is in the back of the book, and all that explanation is there. But basically, through lots of research and thought processes and many, many conversations with people, I came to the conclusion that there is a kind of a feminist approach within Aoife's story. So I took that approach. And obviously within everything that I've written, I invite people to come up with their own understanding of what this means. I just want to say to everybody who I crossed during the journey of writing this book and the journey of my own healing, I suppose. I know that statement has become quite a cliche, but during my own healing, my own journey out of the darkness, shall we say, which is a lot of that is reflected in this book, and I hope that this journey will become somebody else's inspiration to get out of their darkness, because this is a story of transformation. So I was inspired by many people I met along the way, people who I might have just met for that one day, for example. I spoke to them about the book, had intensive conversations, which really opened my mind to new ways of thinking, new ways of approaching the story. And hello to everybody who's watching. I see everybody popping up. So thank you all so much for tuning into my virtual launch. Like I said, I couldn't have a physical one because of COVID. So thank you everyone for tuning in. Childrenoflear.ie, that's my website, where all of the information about the book and where you can buy the book online. So basically, anyway, as I was saying, all the people I met during the journey of this book and writing this was a journey, and I hope for everybody reading it will be a journey. For me going forward with the book, with my performance, will be a journey. So I'm doing this book, I'm performing this book as a dramatic reading as well, which will take place in the Heritage Centre in Nina next week, from the 6th of October to the 9th of October. And I'll be doing a dramatic reading, and I'm taking the inspiration from the old bardic ways of telling stories, which is no set, no costume, no sound equipment, just complete and utter raw performance. And so if you want to book into that, you can message me, and there are only 6 places available because of COVID. This is 6 places per show, so booking is essential. And hello, Stuart, thank you so much. Hello for your lovely comment. Hello, Julie. Hi, Nick. Welcome to my virtual launch. Thank you. So just I was just saying thank you so much to everybody who helped me along this journey. I met people who inspired me from an academic point of view, who inspired me from a spiritual point of view, an emotional point of view, who I was on writing this book was a journey for me, climbing out of the darkness. And I, like I said, I'm rambling on a little bit here now, I know, but met some amazing, wonderful people along the way, and just want to thank them so much who supported me in writing this book. Hi, Stephen. Thank you for joining in. Yeah, and if anybody here has any comments that they want to say or any questions that they want to ask about my book or about anything about it, feel free to do so, to make a comment. So I would just want to talk a little bit more about this, my one-woman show, as I'm calling it. So it is this dramatic reading of the book. My original plan for it was that I wanted to tour it around in a few different places and perform it in really quirky locations, such as, I don't know, a wood or maybe some old mythical site or something. But obviously that's a little bit difficult to plan right now because of COVID and everything. So I just literally have to take day by day, have to go with the flow with that. But for the moment, like I said already, I will be performing this in Nina Heritage Centre from the 6th of October to the 9th of October at 11 a.m. each morning. And yeah, so I think I have said everything that I wanted to say, and I just wanted to thank everyone who, I'm not going to mention any particular names in case I forget people, which will probably likely happen. And but I just wanted to thank everybody who crossed my path on this journey, who inspired me, who helped me write this book, and who helped me, who supported me on my own journey of climbing out of the darkness. And I really hope that this book becomes a comfort for some people when they are climbing out of their own darkness. That's it is a story of transformation, and it is a story of the light coming in. And like I said at the beginning of the video, to if you want to go more in depth about what the book is actually about, like in terms of the storyline, all of that, I have all of that information on my website, childrenoflear.ie. And I'll read a couple of excerpts for you. So let me see. I have the first, I just want to show you the first page. So the first page, it's probably backwards now because it's mirror version, but the first page says, "I turned my suffering into a work of art, and through that I found my freedom." So that's the kind of opening statement of the book. Hi, Margie. Thank you so much for your comment. Hello, everybody who's watching. Thank you. So I'll read the first page, just the very opening of the book. So a character called A opens the book. So A is the eldest son of the four children of Lear, and A's story is told entirely separately from the other characters. And his story challenges our connection with nature and our within society, what's happening in society. But anyway, I will just read the first page. It might be a little bit out of context, but here we go. I'll just read it. And if you want to know more in depth about what the whole story is about, go to my website, childrenoflear.ie. All the information is there. Here's the first page. A. I ran down the slope and I caught my breath. I found my reflection in the puddle. I was lost. I was confused. I was on my hands and knees, breathing heavily, blood in my mouth and nose. What has happened to me? I tried to think. I tried to breathe. I tried to escape. But there was no escape. They were after me, and they wanted to kill me. I had nowhere to hide, nowhere to go. I couldn't run anymore. Trees burning down, fire all around me, smoke rising high, panic. I saw a woman running from a burning tent. So anyway, that's the first page. And yes, so there's another poem I would like to read to you. So the last section, so my book is in three sections. The first section is called A, the second section is called Aoife Fionnuala Lear, and the third section is called Con and Fiacre, the twin journey. So that's the picture there, introductory picture. So Con and Fiacre, just to give you a brief about what their section is about, like I said, all this information is in more detail on my website, childrenoflear.ie. So Con and Fiacre are the twins. They're the youngest of the children of Lear, and my kind of symbolic understanding of their story is somebody losing a part of themselves, and they go on the journey to try and retrieve that part. So it's very abstract poetry. It goes on the journey through the subconscious, and it's very abstract in a way that I allow people to make their own understanding of it, that it will become personal to them, and that's the hope that people will find a part of themselves or comfort or whatever in this story. Anyway, so this particular poem I want to read within their section. This poem, in a way, kind of summarizes what the whole story, really, the overarching theme of this whole story is, which is losing yourself and finding yourself. So here we go. I'll read the poem. The girl with the 1,000 masks. She smiles for a nation, but she cries to herself. She laughs for the people, but she breaks in secret. She cries into her chest, trying not to make a sound. For if they found the secret of her pain, she would find it too hard to live with the shame. The girl with the face that pleases, the girl who smiles and laughs, but under this pretty mask lies a broken doll. Abandoned on a muddy pathway. She believed in her mask. To her, that's who she was. She couldn't withstand the pressure of accepting her tattered past. So she built herself a mask, one she believed to be true. Yesterday, she looked behind her and saw her shattered self, torn into a million pieces by the rough monsters of the night. She lay helpless and covered in ash as they burned her future away. She took a chance and picked up a mask, one that lay in the mud. She wiped it clean and gave it a face. This is who I will be now. The girl with the smile, the girl with the laugh, the girl with the jokes. No one is to know the truth about her broken and battered soul. So she dug a hole that night and buried the secret deep. It screamed at her to stop, but she walked away and never turned back. She grew a new emotion, one of determination, one of independence, an emotion that left her angry. There was one thing she wanted, and that was freedom. No one was to get in her way. She was on a quest to set her soul free. But she didn't realize it was her that locked it away and buried it deep. So that's that one poem. So the Con and Fiacre section is made of made up of a series of poems that together tell that abstract story that journeys through the subconscious. Anyhow, so again, this is just to show you once more, this is the book, and I'll just flick through the pages to show all of my illustrations, and then all beautifully put together and layered by Deirdre Gleason. She has her graphic design name called Sullis Cree. She's on Facebook as Sullis Cree. So this is the book, and it's available to buy online at childrenoflear.ie, and when you buy it online I just give a little signature at the front cover, and I have these lovely bookmarks, so I put in a bookmark as well. There you go. So I think I have said everything that I wanted to say about the book, and thank you everybody for tuning in, and hello Armando, hello Mia, hi Mylene, thank you all so much for tuning in, and for those of you who are around North Tipperary, the book is available to buy in Easons in Nenagh and in Sheila na Gaig in Clochjordan. Otherwise it is available online at childrenoflear.ie, and we'll see where this journey, this is the next journey, we'll see where the book takes me, and anyhow, I hope, thank you all so much for joining in. Bye!